So I've looked at manila phytes and vridia plantae, sporangi and embryophytes that stay on land. But hey, these gymnosperms start off the trees. Cycads are dioecious with pinnate leaves. Cycadaceae sporophylls are toothed with mycorrhizal roots. Zambiaceae's veins are parallel with ovules and twos. Now if you come across a tree out in the landscape, you'll know that it's ginkgo if the leaves are fan-shaped. With conifers I learned they can have non-motile sperm in the Pinus serotinus. Cones open when they're burned. You got the pinaceae and cupressaceae. In fact, the pinaceae sheds its leaves and the others got fused bracts. Now that just might cover half of the spermatophytes, but now you got fruits and flora formulas to write. The amborellaceae have 9 nuclei and 8 little cells. The nymphaceae float and have flowers on long pedicels. The iliaceae have distinct carpels in a whorl, just an evergreen shrub with ethereal oils. Now open up your eyelids and check out these magnoliids. These ananaceae's leaves are simple and extipulate. Magnolia's perianth is indifferent. Piperaceae's nodes are swollen and has a spadix. Aristolochiae lack a corolla, but has a showy calyx. The Lauraceae is one of my favorites. Its inflorescence is auxiliary with 3 tepals and stamens. Now let me break it down in layman's for these next families that I'm naming.